So, how has it been, you know, the things that were suggested?
Yeah,
3 days ago.
It goes now better, but sometimes I just forget the shaping here and I do kind of wrong shaping, then it doesn't go. And it's obvious that I have to do the over shape here.
Right, so sometimes you do it like it's an under shape.
Yes.
And then it doesn't work. Okay, so guess what? You do over shape.
Yes.
You do it as an over shape. You start all the way in and the over shape is not very big. Remember, we're still doing, you know, finger to finger. Right. I just wanted to see if when you start, if you pull out on the first finger, do you? Yeah, go forward. Right.
Ah.
Right, you're inside, but you need, it's the beginning of an overshape. Right. So it's a little bit forward. Right, it doesn't start, I think you start it like straight down.
Yeah,
a little bit
good.
Now
it's good.
Now it's good. Good. So, right, so like one correct motion already makes such a big difference. You know, inside and a little bit of a forward starts. And we have what is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five note over shape. So the high point is the third finger, second finger. And this was, no, one second. I think that, can I just try it?
Yes.
Yeah, it's one shape. So this is the high point. This is a little bit down. And this. And the other thing, I don't know if I got a chance to show you, but actually when you come out on the two, it becomes a little bit of an undershape to the, you know. So I think that what also helps is, again, to know where is the two going to, right?
Okay,
it's
yes.
Not just I'm coming out, but it has a relationship. First of all, just to make sure that that's very clear, the single and the doubles are still working there. It's just a very, very small, and the shape is almost like the movement that glues everything together, you know, the rotation, the in and out, the walking hand and arm, and all that, and it makes it one. But this, you know how much to actually to move out when you relate this last note to here. It's a leap. So, you know, it's a double rotation, staccato, double rotation, leap. Let me just make sure that it's a, yeah. It's a little bit of an under going to and over here. Yeah, but basically to feel it as leaps.
And also, here is the end of the overshape, not here. I just actually practice like, this is the end of overshape, and I do kind of under.
No, it's not an under. I think that you're just getting a little bit higher here, but it's actually, yeah, it's really the end. And you know it because of where it's going next. You know, there's a change of direction. If you do it like lower here and then getting higher, it doesn't work. It doesn't work to take you to the next note here. Right. How's that?
It's good.
It pulls it all together.
Yes, it's,
yeah.
it's now very good.
Is very, very crucial, because if something else, if there were, let's say, other notes that were involved after the two, it wasn't going to the A, it may have been true to come down on the thumb. I don't know if it crossed, and I don't know went to something else. You know, it's very contextual. You know, shaping is very contextual. You know, very much. You know, decisions are made very much on also what's happened. You know, it can be one way if what the next note is, whatever it is, it can be the opposite.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Good. And then, wait, and that's also not the end, because this is going to take you here, right?
Yes.
Right. It can sound like the end of a figure, but it continues. Let's go to the places that bother you. You know,
so
the
here,
things that,
I practice here. So as we discussed before, I just practice only the legatos here.
Right. Okay, now detach it. You know, the only reason that I suggested legato is very often when we detach, we lose the relationship of one finger to the next. But you can give it a little bit of a longer sound because it does complete the set. But it doesn't mean that the arm stays there because then how do you get to here? And it's just an eighth note, but I would give it a sound, you know, a little bit of a longer sound. Good. So let's go to the what's next.
The next place was here, but it just solved all the problems because I actually started from here and then I go all the way in, but now I play.
Right.
And do I have to play also this one here in here?
Let's see. Okay, so what solved the problem was, you know, that before you were out.
Yes.
And now you were going across, which normally is what happens in the exceptions. Okay. So what you're asking is actually, should this be inside?
Yes.
Well, you know something? It's... yes. It doesn't have to be very in. This is already enough to put you right across. You have the movement across and you have a movement in, it's just too much. You know, that's, well, you're complaining, right?
Yes.
If it comes as a complaint, there's something, it must be something better. You know, and doesn't even have to be so short, you know, because when you live in the keys, it's already staccato. It doesn't have to be so.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it feels very, you know, very, I think, too plucked, you know. And you know, so you can also give it, look, the fact that it's detached doesn't mean that they have to sound so separate.
Yes.
They still have a phrasing, right? Bum, bum, bum.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's show. And bring out a little bit of tongue. Right, I think that I do one other thing that will make it feel even better. Look, instead of doing so separate, each one, they do play separately, but they have a shape which makes them, you don't have to do so much of that. You see, it's very close.
Yes.
Just by leaving the keys, you don't have to be here and, you know, all of that. And it gives it a shape, it's more musical. See?
Mm-hmm.
Try it. So just go from one to the other more directly. Right, and then it's going to be a little bit more of a staccato because of the send off, because of the leap. Right. That's it. Right, it can be even more direct. Right. All you have to do, the keys come up, it's staccato already. Right, much less movement. Right there. learning that when less is needed versus when more is needed. Right, send you right. Right. And even that doesn't have to be so short.
Yeah.
The air doesn't, you know, the plane doesn't benefit from all that air,
mm-hmm.
you know, in between.
Yes.
It can be, it's in, sometimes in training, you know, we do a little bit more, but then, very close, just go directly.
Feels actually more like legato to hear now.
That's right. Because it feels more linked. They feel more keys to keys, you know, it feels more like you connected to the piano.
Mm-hmm.
And otherwise, you're up in the air.
Yes.
And it also takes too much time. You're losing time. You know, the moment you lift the keys, you can make it a little bit shorter, a little bit longer, but I wouldn't go to here. I would go to my one. I'm away now. Yeah, it's a little bit of a rebound. Right, and then you can also shape. Right. So it feels much more comfortable physically.
Yes.
And musically, it sounds more like a line.
Mm-hmm.
Rather than separate notes, separate thirds.
But here I get
mute. Exactly, it has to be a stronger send off because it's a greater distance.
Mm-hmm.
So if you do, but if we use the big movement to the very small distance, you know, it's too much movement. This is more exactly we learn to move just according to need.
Mm-hmm.
Right, it has to send you directly to where you're going. Good. Very good. So when you try to get more, don't get more fingery. Get the power from the forearm. Right. Exactly. And less fast into the key, you know, and you get a nice, much more rounded sound.